those arrows you threw them away. You kept falling in love, and then one day when you fell towards me. In the clouds, you found me. Please don't go. I want you so. Increasingly today, we are trying to preserve and protect the species on this planet, to restore our landscapes to their original beauty and save the delicate ecosystems supported by them. The Wye Valley in Wales is renowned for its stunning natural beauty. However, there are still species dying out, and some have disappeared from its forests and hillsides altogether. But there are efforts being made to reverse this. The red kite was on the verge of extinction, with only 6 breeding pairs left in Wales. They were isolated to a small area in Powys, in the mid-Wales valleys. But through the efforts of one farmer, this all changed. Gigwin Farm is now a feeding and rehabilitation centre for red kites, and the birds of prey are fed every day like clockwork. In the 16th century, they were declared vermin and hunted by farmers and landowners. Gamekeepers are no longer allowed to put down poison bait, and so their numbers have quickly soared. So now in winter, over 400 can be seen feeding at Gigwin. It is not only kites that feed here. The crows may look like pests, but the kites look to them for reassurance. Only when the crows come down do the birds of prey know that it is safe for them to feed. Other birds of prey also take advantage of this feast. Buzzards, a common species to Wales, also feed here. They are less fearful of the ground. The red kites are an example of a species brought back from the brink, and we can once again appreciate their beauty in the skies. The red kite's population was affected by their food source, but a lot of animals depend on a certain habitat to survive. Local heath and moorland had a rich ecosystem, but due to commercial forests being grown and farmland being created, it has become scarce. Recently, at 2 sites in the Wye Valley, the original heathland has been reinstated, and small herds of Welsh Mountain and Exmoor ponies have been released. These species were once seen frequently in Wales, and they've now been reintroduced in order to maintain a habitat that has been painstakingly restored.
Well, we're working in partnership with the Forestry Commission. We're trying to restore this area into UK BAP priority habitat, which is dry lowland heath. It's taken an area which before had fairly low biodiversity with the pine trees, and it's recreating a habitat that used to be common right along this area. And we've also done some bracken control, because bracken is a species that tends to over-dominate the site if not controlled. And then once that was done, grasses and things started appearing, which enabled the ponies to come on and start grazing.
An ecosystem is affected when one or more of its elements are removed. By bringing the ponies back, other wildlife benefits. This robin is taking advantage of the insects disturbed by the ponies. Some would oppose the disappearance of the forests.
No major opposition, just a few dog walkers who prefer to see trees, because obviously we had trees here before. But over the last 6 years that we've been developing this site, we've worked quite closely with other bodies like Countryside Council of Wales and Gwent Wildlife Trust and the Wye Valley AOMB, and everybody's been extremely supportive in reintroducing this heathland habitat here. On this particular site, it's 28 hectares, which is quite a big area, and we've got a neighbouring site at Broadmean, that's 13 hectares. So in total we've got just about 40 hectares of heathland in the Wye Valley.
Broadmean is home to a small herd of Exmoor ponies. These are a much more prehistoric race. As non-domesticated ponies, their genes have barely changed over thousands of years. Ironically, although technically wild, these ponies are dependent on human help, as their available range is so small.
Well, the ecosystem here certainly has changed since the ponies have grazed. They started in October, as I say, about 3 years ago. And since then, it's looking more like heathland, or and moorland, I suppose, than just chopped down conifer forest. The heather has come back, and I mean, obviously this time of the year you can't see very much, but it certainly, that they have been doing a good job. They've been eating all manner of things that and helping diversify the ecosystem, I would imagine a lot of the other wildlife that have come in and helped as well. These ponies stay out all year. Exmoors are particularly well designed for this sort of weather. In the winter they grow a double layered thick coat. They've got very big sharp teeth for eating all sorts of harsh vegetation. Their coat is arranged, the whorls on their coat are so arranged to shed water, and they're so well insulated that the snow and frost actually don't melt. It's called snow thatching. And sometimes, when it, like last winter, when it was really snowy, they'd be wandering around all day with this blanket of snow on top, a changed colour. Well, in the summer months, they're very much left to their own devices, really. I mean, we do check them daily. For example, if there's a long dry spell, there is a pond that was dug down there for them, and just to make sure that they have got a water supply. In the winter months, because as you can see it's pretty bleak, we do give them hay, and it is important just to check they're all right. But really they have very little attention. I think it's very important to protect our native species, particularly when they're designed to do such a good job. And personally, I don't see the point of importing creatures from abroad when we've got some here that can do the job perfectly well.
The habitat here is a virtuous circle. The land relies on the ponies to be maintained, and the ponies need the land to remain self-sufficient.
What we're looking at, this type of habitat, was very quite abundant sort of 200 years ago. All the species associated with this heathland open space have been slowly dying out, so by conserving it and maintaining it, we feel that we're doing good for the environment.
This is like a little oasis for the wildlife in amongst a big forestry plantation, really.
By helping restore the land, we also help the animals that depend on it, and so give them both a second chance.